Hey everybody, and welcome to part 14 of Ratchet and Clank, Up Your Arsenal. So, I'm back here because there's an evil enemy out there that's seriously ready to kill me, so... kinda have to hide away from him, and man, they give you a lot of experience, but at the same time they take a bit to kill. So they do kind of waste ammo. Oh, we also got the Rift Inducer. The Rift Inducer creates small black holes that suck enemies into another dimension. This gun is probably one of the best guns in the main part of the game. Not like the challenge run or anything like that. It's just amazing. Does so much damage, and usually I have it here, which is sad that I don't, because I wasn't really looking forward to using this, but... boink. And boink.
Double tap R1 to blast off with the charge boots.
Wait, you have to tell me that now? Wow, that levels up fast. See, you just have to get higher up where they... you fight weak enemies, but at a high point in the game. Let's try this. Ooh, this is... actually doesn't do bad damage to them. I think our nanotech killed that guy because we didn't get the experience for it on our weapon. Saddening. Spinning Hydra is V4 though, right? Yeah. Ooh, there's 5 enemies to hit? I don't know what the enemy it is, what's hitting it from behind.
The jackpot crate
Yeah, I know it multiplies experience. You tell me this every darn time we play this game. I don't know why you need to tell it to me every damn time. Can you kill that guy? He's worth a lot of experience. Not as worth as much as expecting for the jackpot crate. Also, I still kind of need to get the Annihilator. For some reason, I have not bought it yet. I feel like we're missing bolts. Yeah, at the same time, I'm ahead of what I normally am at this point. Maybe I just buy different weapons. Anyways, we got some hacking to do. Like I said, this is just very boring. Not difficult, just extremely boring. Apologize if you guys hate watching this, but it seriously is really boring. And I'm not just gonna edit out because it is part of the game. And you guys do want to see me, you know, play legitimately, like not cheat or anything like that. Actually, I don't even know if there are any cheats to like beat the game. I know like a lot of the cheats back then were to like get the demos for like the games. So you just hold down L1, L2, R2, and R1 to like get a demo at the beginning. Like the loading screen, but... or like the title screen, not the loading screen. So I don't know if there's like actual cheats, unless you have like some kind of like Game Shark. Okay, so far so good, I guess, taking these guys down. Or not really down. More like blowing them up and sucking these things up. That was a really easy one. Boink. Why did you miss that one? Hurry up. And there we go. Done. We activated the elevator. Good thing these things save. Now, what kind of enemies do we have up here to deal with? Ooh, for sure I want to kill him with the sniper rifle. These little guys, I want to use my plasma whip because it's falling so far behind. Dude, there's another one. Go figure. Is this thing seriously a one-shot kill? Man, it seems overpowered. Now, I do believe there is a titanium bolt. Yep, up there. And see, this is also the spot where Ratchet could get the whole jackpot thing done as well. For some reason, we don't get the whole animation for that, and there's another door right there. God damn it. It's really not looking forward to doing more of this. So boring. I hate using the hacker. But let's do it. Oh yeah, this one's starting off all green. I like this. Yes. Perfect. Man, I love when it's just quick like that. Makes it so much easier. And less time consuming and less annoying. Hey, so what do you guys want to talk about while I do this? As to Let's Plays, this game and Future Tools of Destruction are probably some of my most viewed Let's Plays other than Yoshi's Island, and only the beginning of Yoshi's Island. Later on, it wasn't really loved that much. As much as people say they watched the entire series, it's like, clearly if I'm, like, if I still have parts that have zero views, it means you haven't watched it, guys. I hate to break it to you, I can tell when you guys watch my content. It's kind of obvious and self-explanatory. If you watch the video, it's going to gain a view. Also, I can monitor how many minutes you guys watch on a video, so I can tell if you guys are watching it all the way through or not. A lot of people think just getting views is what makes you money. No, you need to get likes, and then you need to view the video for its entirety of the entire length of it. Now, I always thought this spot had... Maybe it doesn't. Oh, apparently my gun's not gonna come out. Boink. I swear the big green guys were supposed to be there, but I think they're just over here. Should be, yeah, right here. Well, since these guys fall off a cliff, they die anyway. Wow. That's very easy. They do a large chunk of damage to you, though, which I despise. And, ooh, more of these little guys. Oh, good damn it! It's an actual ship. A dropship that actually wants to attack me. Why are the Tyranoids working for a guy who hates squishies? Doesn't that seem kind of... just, like, out there, you know? Oh, schnitz. Ooh, this looks like it's gonna be dangerous. Ooh, he actually hit me, that bugger. I believe even these guys do a lot of damage. It's just, they're easier to kill, luckily. Okay. Oh, they only take two hits with this weapon. That's just how overpowered it is. Well, let's grab some more ammo and stuff. Eh, some more ammo is just sitting there. An Inferno Crate. You know what? Screw the Inferno Crate. I don't really find it to be that useful. Man, how much does the Infector do? So I'm pretty sure we could level this thing up to B2. There we go! B2! Bloop. You guys can shoot each other with it. Oh, there's apparently a... Oh, wait, that's the switch to change the weather. That I always like that. That's cool. Oh, Agents of Doom. Do you guys kill these guys fast? Fairly fast. And you get some decent experience. Not the best in the world. Oh, never mind. Ooh, little guys. Ugh. There we go. Oh, shit, it's a big green guy. God damn it. Two big green guys. Oh, god damn it. Huh. Woo! Thank heavens for the nanotech increase there, man. Spitting Hydra, go! I believe this is actually the checkpoint right here.
Clank, where have you been? I thought something happened to you.
I was... having my sprockets lubed.
You picked a fine time for a tune-up. Where's Courtney Gears?
Miss Gears has left the planet.
What? What about Nefarious? Did she tell you where he is?
Dr. Nefarious is aboard a star cruiser called the Leviathan.
Okay. Nice job, Clank. So, I'll just call Sasha and have her track down that star cruiser.
Oh, that doesn't look good. He's turning red. Now, I believe to get other stuff... Whoa, camera angles. The camera angles here suck. Okay, why... Okay, it's like I was permanently stuck in wall climbing mode. What the hell, man? Oh. Hey there, buddy. Okay, apparently that weapon doesn't want to target him. Okay. The game is getting weird as balls here right now. Ooh, plasma whip enemies. Perfect. And then we got more displays. Oh yeah, these guys only take one hit. I was so used to the spinning hydra there that we were just using. Can you stop with the camera angle? Okay, apparently my gun is not working here. The display gun was not working. And V3.
This weapon upgrade features
a— why does this one have a lock-on mod?
To lock on to enemies, press and hold L2 and R2.
Seems like a weird upgrade for the lava gun. You know, like, why does a lock-on mod seem like a useful ability? See, this gun sucks if you can't specifically target them, though. You know what? You guys are stuck up there, aren't you? Okay. Never mind. N60 Storm, go. Why is he pointing at the ground? Okay, I'm just gonna die here because I can't kill these enemies. Because the camera angle is not agreeing with me, so let's get the hell out of Dodge. The hell, game? Oh, great, big guy. Oh. You're one of the random big guys that takes more than one hit to kill. How I love you guys so much. That's not what I wanted, I want this. Ooh, wait, these are tier nodes. Oh, come on! That's bullshit. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, come on! Okay, apparently I'm not gonna be able to abuse this. Okay, so I apparently can't even aim at them because of the camera angle. Go freaking figure. And we got the titanium bolt. Sheesh. Oh, great. Can we please get out of this camera angle?
Hey, kid. How's the stakeout going?
Awesome. A few minutes ago, this totally tricked out space limo rolls up, and dude, you won't believe who was in it. Courtney Gears!
Uh-oh. Were you spotted?
No way, man. I've been staying out of sight, keeping a low profile. I'm like a shadow, dude.
And you're sure it was her?
Totally. She even autographed my t-shirt.
Ugh.
You know how much this thing is worth?
Skid, get out of there!
Hold on a sec, bro. Somebody's coming. Hey, if you dudes are here about the shirt, the bidding starts at 300 bolts. Whoa, chill out, man. Hey!
Skid's in trouble. We better get back to the Obani Moons.
Well, it looks like we're going to the Obani Moon first. Obani Draco, find Skid. So, let's go to the third moon. Kind of figure this came after Hollow Star Studios. There's no skill point here at all, other than, you know, get to the belt, because the Abani moons count as one planet. This game has a lot of planets that are literally used for, like, maybe 10 minutes, and then you never come back to it. Like, even the Florana Jungle, we got the skill point, the trophies, and everything there, and it was literally worth, like, 10 minutes of video. Oh. Okay. Apparently I can use that. We got the little robots here, which the little robots I know for a fact we can kill with the plasma whip. So this should be fairly easy to level it up. Like this guy, it's leveling up decently. Yeah, I think there's an enemy there. Oh, some of them are just phasing in with the ground. Not sure why, but they are. Now, this stuff is instant death goo, so don't touch it. You'll die. Boom. Meow. There we go. Plasma Whip V4.
Strafing is a very effective tactic during a firefight. To strafe, hold down L2 or R2 while running.
Except there's no firefight, so I really don't know what you're getting at. It's more like some electrical platforming. Meow. Now we got stuff going on in here. Continue point. It's a disco ball. This moon seems really, really disco ball-ish. See, this weapon still levels up fairly quickly. I think now we're only killing like one enemy here and there, instead of big swarms of them. Oh, so now we got a ton of enemies in this area. Like, look at that, man. That's a good experience. Might have to go and farm some of the little enemies. I believe the next planet's actually Metropolis, but to figure that out, we're gonna have to do a court vid comic. Which I'm not looking forward to, because I believe we might actually have to do two. I think it's two. We might not have to. But there's five altogether in the entirety of the game, and we have to do them all. Strafing? It's okay here. Ow. See, strafing got me hurt. Only strafing would do that.
This is the testing laboratory for the Bio-Obliterator.
Let's see what Nefarious has been up to.
Whoa! Like I never knew you were this kinky, Ms. Gears.
Don't you ever shut up.
Okay, I'll zip it. Man, the guys aren't gonna believe this.
Like, destroy all squishies, dude.
What? They turned Skid into a robot? That's impossible!
Not for Dr. Nefarious.
Don't be afraid, Ratchet. The transformation doesn't hurt. Much.
Oh, snap.
Besides, I think you'll enjoy being a robot.
Let's see if you can fight better than you can sing.
Well, let's see if that's true. Cause here we go! Die, Courtney Gears! I'm gonna take down a pop star! I love how we get to listen to her song in the background, though. Probably one of the most epic boss fights of all time, just due to the music. I'm not a rat! Oh yeah, nanotech increase in the middle of taking damage. Don't you just love when that happens? Man, how many minions do you have? Boink. Boink. Oh yeah, eat my eruptor. Gotta love fully upgraded weapons, eh? Oh damn it. Oh man. Keep like mistiming my shots. I just hear the lyrics in my head, you know? Now how much does the Oops. Oops, you did it. She is a Britney Spears ripoff. Die, Britney Spears. Wait, they actually give you health here? I never knew that. I don't remember them ever giving you health here. Now can I actually like kill you with my whip? Yeah, there we go.
One disposable pop star disposed.
You okay, Clank?
Transmission from the Phoenix.
We've located Nefarious' star cruiser. It's refueling at the Zeldrin starport. Quark is already on his way there.
It might be a trap. I think Courtney Gears was setting us up. Even so, it could be our only chance to stop Nefarious. We'll meet Quark at the starport.
Be careful, Ratchet.
Come on, Clank. We'll come back for Skid later.
Like, destroy all squishies and stuff.
Well, I guess we're coming back for them. Jural Nebula, starport. So I guess we'll be doing that in this episode as well, because I do want to get it done now. Because next episode we're going to have to do the Quark vid comic. Go to the Zeldrin starport. That's literally the picture of Annihilation Nation. I guess Annihilation Nation is the same kind of setup as the starport is. And just a battle arena starport instead of a refueling starport. I've always liked the concept of space, you know, being able to go to outer space and do this stuff. It just doesn't feel like human technology is advancing that fast. Like, it's advanced, but like I still have to wear glasses. We still have cancer. We still have all this. It's like, clearly it's not advanced that much. Ooh, lots of money.
Are no longer permitted as carry-on baggage.
Hey, Gadgetron lady, what are you doing here? I believe there's actually a new weapon here, too. Nope, never mind. Now, if you want to end it really quickly, just go over there. We are actually going to go over here first. And yes, Nefarious has ninjas and more troopers. Oh god, these guys actually take a lot of hits. Well, I mean for the weapon, like, it's upgraded to V4 and it's still doing that little. Man, remember when it was one of those overpowered weapons? Oh, I hear some enemies. Oh. Well, they're all dead. And we just got- oh, we got a jackpot crate, apparently. This is a good way to get some money right now. I missed some boxes over there, but I'll be back. I don't know if there's a skill point here, though. Oh, goddammit, they got those guys again from his base. Clearly tell his ship's here. And there we go!
The deadly Gadgetron Tempest can target up to 7 enemies simultaneously.
Oh, that's so amazing, can target up to 7. That's all it does? Alright. Storm, let's do this. Oh, shit! I didn't realize that was a clip and I needed a swing shot. I, for some reason, never seen this swing shot. That was just dumb, I apologize.
Boink.
Like, I don't mind getting the extra experience here, that's why I'm not angry. By the time this weapon kills something, it's like almost out of ammo. Oh, okay. More ninjas. Die, ninja. It's weird that the ninjas don't just blow up. Oh, my computer's trying to fall asleep on me again. See, I'm trying to get into the habit of making longer videos for you guys. Just, I don't want the static and stuff to happen again, so I'm a little more cautious on that note. Now, let's see. This gun does a lot, right? Oh, it's no longer insta-kill! Oh, it still kills him in 2 hits. And he's dead because he's gonna fall in the lava anyway. Oh, there you are. I don't know why you're hiding out over there, man. But it still levels up like it's a weak weapon, you know? Fire! Ah! Can you stop hitting me? There we go, that's what I'm talking about. The duty-free shopping area. Now, is it free of duty, like as in poo, or is it you don't have to work there? Yeah, those guys take 2 hits as well. Just the one guy fell in the lava, so we couldn't tell how much it took to kill him. Now, on the other hand, flux rifle is enough to take him down. That one guy survived. There we go! The V4 on the flux rifle. This is a great place to level up your weapons.
Your safety is important to us. Please stay clear of all
decorations. Okay, ooh, some health. Well, of course you're gonna stay clear of lava. Oh my lord. Wait, you level up to V2? When did that level up to V2? I did not know it leveled up. There we go. Agents of Doom V3. God, I love when my weapons upgrade. Wait, there's nothing this way? I guess it's just like a port. Oh, this looks like it's gonna have some nice enemies to kill. Or just 2 of these guys. Like, I think it's because like they have like weird sniping skills. There we go, you can kill him. You can destroy these ships, you can. For some moolah. Not very much, though. Hey, why are you guys not attacking him anymore? Dummies. Your guys' whole purpose is to kill enemies. Oh, there's still enough of you to kill a ninja. Guys, there's still a ninja here. I could hear you following me. And I'm not talking about the ninja following me. I'm talking about my goo. See, I still have a little guy. Don't know why he wasn't attacking the ninja. Like, dude, I don't have to do everything myself. Alright. This ninja's crazy. And does over 20 damage. Well, a little less than 20 damage in one hit. Ooh, Jesus, that guy hurts. Oh man, more of you! This is a long pathway. There, I should literally do the lock-on mod so I can see his health. That way I don't waste ammo. Well, we almost have enough for the Annihilator. The Annihilator is a decent weapon. Though there are some more, Ranger missions coming up soon, so we can get some more money that way. Plus, we still get some more missions at Annihilation Nation, where we just don't have the weapons to do so. Can you guys, like, just please die up there? Now it's a one-shot kill. Nope, never mind. Guess only if they're not fully at full health. I was gonna say fully healed. They don't actually technically heal. Oh, that ninja just dropped. Organic life forms must be kept on a leash. I guess they're only allowed organics if they're pets. Ooh, more nanotech. This place is upgrading us like crazy. Like, holy cow. Oh, and there's the item we came for. Yeah, it's a bonus item. You don't need it, but it is good to have. So let's grab it. Another beautiful collectible. The Bolt Grabber V2. I believe this is the one that has, like, the earthquake effect. So anyways, guys, in the next episode, we will be continuing on and dealing with Quark. I'll actually fix up my quick select and... Or, well, before the next